Putin opened Saturday's talks with representatives of Senegal, Egypt, Zambia, Uganda, Congo Republic, Comoros, and South Africa in a palace near St. Petersburg by stressing Russia's commitment to the continent. But after the presentations from Comoros, Senegal, and South African presidents, he stepped in to challenge the assumptions of the plan predicted on acceptance of internationally recognized borders before a round of statements could go any further. Russian President Vladimir Putin gave African leaders a list of reasons why he believed many of their proposals were misjudged, pouring cold water on a plan already largely dismissed by Kiev. Putin told the African leaders Ukraine had already refused talks. As the African delegation called for the return of children to their families, Mr. Putin interrupted their speech and claimed Russia was protecting them. President Ramaphosa also warned Russia's Putin of the impacts of war in Africa and said it should be settled via diplomacy.
We were here. We heard of missile strikes. And those types of activities are not good for fostering peace. And we argue that there must be de-escalation on both sides so that peace can find a way to resolve the problem.
The war cannot go on forever. All wars have to be settled and come to an end at some stage. And we are here to communicate a very clear message that we would like this war to be ended. The war has severely restricted the export of grain from Ukraine and fertilizer from Russia, which has affected African countries in particular and intensified global food insecurity. But Putin blamed the West for the grain crisis, not the war in Ukraine. As he said, only 3% of the grain exports permitted under the UN sponsorship deal to ensure its safe passage through the Black Sea and gone to the world's poorest countries.
We do believe that this is the time for both parties to negotiate, an end to this war, because this war is causing a great deal of instability and harm to various countries around the world. And we as African countries are feeling the impact of this war.
I would like to emphasize that Russia treats with great respect the principal position of African states in favor of maintaining global and regional stability and security, the peaceful settlement of conflicts, and the formation of a more just model of international relations.
Seven African leaders have traveled to Ukraine and Russia on a peace mission, hoping to work towards the end of this war, which has badly affected livelihoods across the continent. The African delegation, made up of representatives from South Africa, Egypt, Senegal, Congo-Brazzaville, Comoros, Zambia, and Uganda, has been specifically designed for breadth and balance with members from different parts of Africa with different views on the conflict. The delegation also met with Ukraine leaders on Friday, where President Ramaphosa warned the war in Europe has affected between 1.2 and 1.3 billion people in Africa.